things that we are doing in January, coming January, we will be having, again, our fourth annual Mayors Against Human Trafficking Conference. And we're looking to have that again. We just, you know, do it the same day every, you know, Wednesday and Thursday of January. So we are looking now, we have a wonderful setup. Also, the victims of trafficking are now survivors. Now, when we bring you a survivor, these are survivors that JB's Foundation, that we have helped. So because we want you to see the work that we're doing, we want you to see that we are out there saving lives, and we need your support so that you all can help us to do that, not just in Orlando, but in your towns as well. We also have, I have been heading along with us, Dr. Karen Peoples is with us. She's a part of JB's Foundation. Dr. Karen, can you please come up? Can I give Dr. Karen a second? Now, just to give you a little bit about Ms. Peoples, it's also, she works with JB's Foundation as well, with Wings of Hope. And Wings of Hope is something that deals with those who have been sexually abused. And she has been providing such a tremendous plan in what we call drama therapy that is supporting the actual helping our kids and helping adults to identify this sexual crime. Now, one of you all, some of you may know that Mercedes Benz South Orlando had adopted.
It's a pleasure to be here in historic Tuskegee. I'm N.Y. Nethiri with the Association to Preserve the Edenville Community. I'm going to invite everyone who is seeing this or is hearing my voice to come to the 31st annual Zora Neale Hurston Festival of the Arts and Humanities, Thursday, January 30 through Sunday, February 2. Orlando is the international airport. We're having an inaugural Africa-America Women's Economic Forum and Trade Expo. And we're inviting all of our sisters and brothers from everywhere in the human family to come to Orlando and historic Edenville 2020, Thursday, January 30th through Sunday, February 2. Our email address is ny@preserveedenville.org. That is ny@preserveedenville.org. And visit our website beginning at the end of October 2019, zorafestival.org. ZORAFestival.org. Thank you.
Well, today we're having a historic Black Towns and Settlements Alliance. First annual cultural tourism conference. It's Cultural Heritage and Tourism Conference here in the city of Tuskegee, along with the World Conference of Mayors and the Alabama Conference of Black Mayors. Mayor Ford was a founding member in those organizations, and we are all members of the various organizations. All that's coming together today at the municipal complex on Saturday. Again, today we'll have activities this evening, activities Sunday, Monday, and through Tuesday. It's mainly workshops and board meetings. Board meetings of the Alabama Conference of Mayors, the World Conference of Mayors, and the Historic Black Towns and Settlements Board meeting as well. And in addition to the conference, where we have different speakers to talk about health, talk about culture, heritage, and tourism, talk about opportunities in our community and how to serve our people in our communities.
Now, where do we draw people from today?
We're drawing people from Benin, Africa. We're drawing people from Nigeria, who came all the way from Nigeria. We're drawing people from all over the United States, from Edenville, Florida, outside of Orlando. We have mayors from Grambling, Louisiana, one of the historic settlements. Mayors from Mound Bayou, Mississippi. Mayors from Hobson City, Alabama, all over the state of Alabama, all over the Southeast.
Now, what do you hope to develop from this?
Well, the main thing we hope to develop is see more tourism develop in our communities around our heritage and our culture. You have African-American history and culture all over the United States, and we don't take advantage of it economically. In Edenville, they have a major festival every year, the Zora Neale Hurston Festival. And Dr. NY Nethiri does an excellent job with her team putting that together to generate millions of dollars. So we want to learn how to do that in our communities, how to take advantage of our cultural history and heritage and use the tourism part of it to generate revenue in our communities and opportunities for our people in our communities.
Well, all right. Now, you're doing it at the right time, too, with Exit 38 showing out like they are.
Oh, yeah. We're coming along. That's an additional part of tourism opportunities as we provide something, be able to provide something to eat and hope to have a hotel there by next year. So it'll be somewhere to stay. We'll be opening up our terminal building at the airport, so we have a terminal where people fly into, and other things out at Exit 38. So we think it's a great time.
Okay, so now, what do you need from the community that you guys are doing all of this stuff from a government perspective?
Well, the main thing we need from the community is to help us keep a clean community and emphasize what we're being told by Dr. Nethiri is good customer service. When people come to our community, we want to welcome them. We want to make them happy that they're here, be glad, and feel comfortable so that they spend their money and they come back. Yesterday we had, because of our relationship and my relationship with Colonel Sparrow and his connection to the Red Tails Foundation, he had his commissioning, his promotion from Colonel Sparrow to General Sparrow. He's now a Brigadier General. It was held at Moulton Field, historic Moulton Field, at the Tuskegee Airmen's Museum. We had six generals in our small city yesterday for that event from all over the United States.
Wow.
And all kind of ranking officers in the military. That highlighted Tuskegee again in our part in history as things happen. But it's because of the relationships we've established with people, welcoming them to our community, getting them to feel good and understand the history we have here and the history that we played throughout the United States. And so he felt compelled to bring people here to understand that we're trying to rebuild and strengthen that heritage for young people who will go into aviation like the Tuskegee Airmen. Only 2% of African Americans are in the Air Force right now, and basically as pilots, and they're determined to expand that number. And he, along with other African, along with African Americans, have developed a foundation that will work on training young people as pilots. They right now have about 15 people that on scholarship through their foundation to become pilots. And the first one, Torius, has trained other pilots. And he's just a senior at Tuskegee University.
Oh, wow.
So it's a program to teach people how
planting
to become pilots.
Planting some serious seeds.
Planting some serious seeds. And it's already showing off the developments from that.
Well, all right. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Well, we just look forward to continuing to partner with the community on things that are happening in Tuskegee, and we appreciate this patience of the citizens, because if we take patience and continue our effort and the work that so many are doing to keep our city looking good and to give out the good spirit of welcome to people, I think things will continue to grow.